currently on the last part of this three-part series. We're on hole seven. I'm one over par, so you know I'm not playing terrible. If you guys didn't already know this series, it is hitting a butter knife one iron off every single tee, even par threes. So my last three finishing holes, I got a par four, par three, and another par four. Once again, I'm one over. Either way, if you haven't checked out part one or two, be sure to do that so you can kind of get filled in on the information. I'm sorry if I'm kind of squinting. The sun is literally like right behind the camera. Let's get right in to today's round. Hole seven here, dog leg left. Everything bounces left, so you kind of have to hit it up the right side and it will kick left back into the fairway. Obviously hitting the one iron. Should be fine, but I hit it so far on the toe, it literally went like nowhere. All right, to give you guys a little perspective, I typically have 100 yards into this hole. I have 200 yards into this hole right now. And when I have 100 yards, I'm hitting a hybrid. I just hit a one iron. I know I hit it on the toe, but like even if I hit a hybrid on the toe, I'm still probably gonna have like, you know, 115. It's just unbelievable how when you like miss hit old clubs, they literally go nowhere. It's downwind, downhill. It's 200 yards, you guys are gonna kinda laugh, but I'm hitting seven iron. It should be enough in theory, so I'm just gonna swing at it. Pin's on the right here. Pin high, left, just missed left. This like slope kind of made me draw it and turn it over. So yeah, I mean, I'm not too mad with it. I think we're chipping, but it's not a big deal. Left to right chip, downhill, sloping away from me. I'm gonna hit a 52, little bump and run action here. Yeah, I could putt this one, but I just don't really feel comfortable with my putting today. This is for birdie, if you didn't already know. Out left, and let it run down to the right. We'll take it. Alright, looks like we got an 8-footer here. I thought it was like a 6 or 7 footer, I couldn't really tell. I'm just gonna like roll it right in here. Just let it trickle on in, hopefully. Take par there. It's been a very boring round. We are currently one over going into the last two holes. If I birdie one of them, I'm going to be extremely happy. Even if I par them both, one over is not a bad score for me. Hole eight here is like 185, so it's an in-between club. I obviously can't swing full, but I can't just like, you know, half swing it. But basically, we're just going to hit like a buttercut one iron, the usual. One iron has seemed to be the consistent play off the tee. I'm pretty comfortable with it, so yeah, we're gonna go with one iron. Typically you would want to hit around a 5-6 iron, but you know, one iron will work. It's up the hill, there's no wind anymore, which I'm very thankful for. Might try and land this one short of the green. We actually rolled off the green. It landed just short of the fairway and just kept on going. No lie, I'm actually pretty shocked. There's my ball right down there. I'm gonna stop walking so it's not shaking. The ball literally landed all the way down there, short of the fairway. You could probably see it on camera. But looks like we got a birdie putt. If I could make this, that would be pretty clutch, but I'm not even complaining if I make par. This was definitely the hole that I was kind of scared about coming into. It's probably one of the harder ones for, you know, hitting a one iron off the tee. Let's do it.
Alrighty, right to left breaking putt. Let's do it. Right here. can't make a birdie putt today.
Oh well, I'll take par. All right, walking off of hole 8, we got one more hole to go. I'm gonna feel like a failure if I can't birdie the last. But if I don't, I'm actually not gonna be that mad, one over par. Hitting one iron off every tee, it just feels different, you know? It makes me respect golf like 60 years ago so much more. And I always have respected it a lot, but it's just like, it's crazy how privileged we are to have the ability to use all these super nice clubs. It's like, these clubs are unbelievably different. I'm telling you, like, this one iron, if you miss it, you're screwed. If you miss like a two iron even, like, or a hybrid, for example, we got hybrids now in place of like one irons. If you miss those, you're totally fine. Maybe 20 yards max of lost distance. So I don't know if you guys agree or disagree, but I think we are very privileged in the fact that we have all these nice clubs today, and I'm never going to take it for granted after doing this challenge. I will be doing a thrift shop challenge, so stay tuned for that. It's going to be kind of fun. We're going to go buy a bunch of old clubs and you know, play around golf and see what we can do. But I actually love the challenge of using old clubs. It's a blast. I'm rambling. We are on the last hole, hole 9. Sorry, the sun is like, anyway, it's a doggy left. That's where we're kind of aiming at there.
All right, I'm gonna hit one iron here. Oh yeah. Little knockdown. That was actually struck very well.
All right, last approach shot of the day. I got a 56 degree in hand. I got 100 yards. I haven't hit a close shot all day. It would be very nice to actually make a birdie on the last hole. Be kind of a bonus, but if I don't, whatever. Either way, I got this 56 degree. I'm gonna play a little knockdown shot, keep it a little lower, one hop stop. I'm gonna kind of minimize the spin on this one.
Left.
Walking up to my ball, like I said, 15 feet left for birdie. It'd be super clutch if I could make it. Yeah, let's see what we can do. It's breaking left to right yet again. I feel like I've had a lot of left to righters today.
Gave it a run. Hard to shoot one over for 9 holes, hitting a one iron off every tee box.
So unfortunately, I forgot to do the outro in the car. So I'm currently doing the outro at my house after I just finished a round, drove home anyway. I hope you guys enjoyed this 3-part series. If you did, be sure to stay tuned for more videos in the future. Videos similar to this, challenges, course vlogs, you name it, whatever it may be. I'm trying to upload daily, so I hope you appreciate that. I'm putting like 4 to 5 hours every day into this. I love making videos, as you guys probably already noticed. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, be sure to stay tuned. Peace, guys.